2015's Daredevil is known to be one of the best shows of all time, especially in the Marvel department. Hello guys, what's up? In today's documentary, we're going to look at why Daredevil is such a good show, from seasons 1 all the way to season 3. So let's get right into it. Season 1 of Daredevil. Just to give you a quick brief of who Daredevil is. Daredevil is a crime fighter and lawyer, Matt Murdock, who lives in Hell's Kitchen, New York. He's a vigilante by night who is Daredevil and a lawyer by day. He was blind when he was 9 years old due to an accident that gave him heightened abilities, heightened senses like hearing and smell. He uses this to fight crime at night to try to keep the city safe from a villain named Wilson Fisk or Kingpin, who has ways of fixing the city. However, though, Matt Murdock and him don't see eye to eye, and that causes them to clash throughout this entire season. Matt's trying to save the city while trying to keep his identity safe, and Wilson Fisk is trying to save the city despite the fact that he is hurting people, but he thinks his way is the best way. So that's just a little brief mention of the case. Matt has two friends, Foggy Nelson and Karen Page, who are his associates, as well as a nurse who checks in on him, Claire Temple. Anyway, now that you got the characters out of the way, overall story and gist of Daredevil, let's get into season one. So I think the real thing of season one is the action is absolutely amazing. There is one scene in particular that's very cool, and that is the episode 2 infamous hallway, one take hallway fight scene. Not even joking, this was all done in one shot. Charlie Cox did a really good job with this, and the reason why the fight scene, especially this one, feels so pure is because this fight scene honestly is so incredible because it's all done in one take. You can see Daredevil leans against the wall, he takes breaths, he takes breaks, he stops, he starts to get tired. You can tell that by his choreography, and that just is so real to me. That looks so real, feels so real, where in the other superhero shows, you know, some of the characters will keep fighting and they never run out of energy, and it just seems a little unrealistic, whereas he leans against walls, he's tired, you know, he's not at the top of his game because he's starting to run out of energy. So that's just a little thing about the choreography. The fighting is all really well done. It feels pure, the hits are really good, you know, the effects are really good on the blood. Yeah, there's a lot of blood in this series, which is realistic. You know, there's a lot of gunfire. I mean, you know, the action is very good with weaponry or just hand-to-hand combat. It's really, really cool. I was going to say, the acting this season is really, really cool. From D'Onofrio to Cox, both actors absolutely deliver their roles perfectly. They can be charming, they could be brutal, it just works. And the supporting cast are absolutely fabulous as well. Being supporting cast, trying to get on the action, and trying to be true to their own characters. The setting of this show also makes very much sense. This is Hell's Kitchen, New York, a neighborhood known for a lot of sketchy crime and sketchy people. And the show does that very, very well. I also have to give credit to other two villains this season, Bob Gunton, who played Leland Owsley, and Toby Leonardo Morph, who played James Wesley. These are two associates of Wilson Fisk who absolutely take their roles very nicely in a very good direction, and they just seem so seriously and so badass while staying, you know, true again to their characters, and they just seem very sketchy and very New York City crime-like. So this whole season is good between the action and the acting, and the story itself contains some of the best storytelling ever. We get to see a lot of, you know, we get to see a lot of Matt's backstory, which kind of leads into season 2 and stuff like that. And season 1 is just really cool because of storytelling, the action, and the acting. So that's all for season 1 of Daredevil, and it's really, really cool how it was pretty much done in that state. So yeah. Now we move on to season 2 of Daredevil. So this follows the story after Wilson Fisk is defeated in season 1 and all that stuff. We get, you know, Matt, who is trying to, he's trying to, you know, continue to be Daredevil, but he, you know, his friends are starting to get more and more suspicious, as well as there's a new threat. Matt, the thing about Matt Murdock is that he doesn't kill people as Daredevil, he only hurts some. But then there's a new guy on the loose who will kill criminals, and he is the Punisher, played by Jon Bernthal, who takes the role very, very nicely. He's very violent, he's very real, and he's very pure, and the way he talks is pretty cool, and just the way he acts is pretty cool. This season does show Punisher and Daredevil biting heads, but they eventually do give in to each other, and they eventually do, Matt tries to support, the Punisher in court and all that, but Foggy also worries that Matt might not come home one day. His friends starting to get more and more suspicious. So yeah, that's one thing. The Punisher is very violent and all that other stuff like that. But then he gets pulled into an organization, the Hand and all that. And pretty much the Hand is some like ninja organization, and his girlfriend Elektra, who's played by Elden Young, plays a role fine, comes into the picture. Scott Glenn, who played his trainer as a young child, Stick, comes into the picture, and it's, you know, they have to fight these ninjas, the Hand, who threaten New York City, and Matt thought he ran them out of the city, but he didn't, and they're back, and they're ready to take the city and, you know, fight and all that other stuff. And Pain is truly coming. So, yeah, Claire and Matt's relationship gets a little rocky, and they do part ways and no longer friends. So, yeah, pretty much in the end, it's a nice season with, the Punisher and in the Hand. The action's a little bit better with, the whole ninja and all that. The ninja fighting's really cool. The Punisher's, the gunfire and all that, and, like, the really harsh scenes and very violent scenes are done very, very well. And it just gets very, very crazy with these two very violent characters, Daredevil and Punisher, in the season together, doing their business, and it just makes the season all that well, and better as well. The acting, again, is still, as I said before, really, really good this season, and the storyline is really, really good and easy to follow. You got, the Hand, and you also got the Punisher, and they kind of do lean into each other in a really cool way, where they go on at the same time, so it doesn't feel like they ditch one storyline for another, which they really didn't do. We also get revealed that Wilson Fisk eventually hires the Punisher to set out and kill his enemies for him, and then, the whole thing with that. And Wilson Fisk finally does run a prison, and that will play into Season 3, where he's able to take control of the prison that he currently is in. And now that he takes control of the prison, he is fine. He does very, 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 very well, and that's all that really is to it with this season. Elektra does die, which, is pretty, pretty sad and all that, and it's played like that. By the end of the season, Matt is still Daredevil, but he's trying to separate himself now from Daredevil because he doesn't want to go through a Punisher. He doesn't want to go to that Punisher point where he's going to kill someone. He doesn't want to cross that line. Which is something he fights himself on very nicely this season, He talks to a person that will kill people, and he doesn't want to become the Punisher, and he almost becomes the Punisher, but his good for respect for human life keeps him from crossing that Punisher line of killing people. He thinks that everyone deserves a second chance, even if they are the baddest of all people. They still all do deserve a second chance. However, by the end of the season, he's starting to wonder if, he should just ditch being Matt Murdock, because that violent wave of the Punisher, or that violent, that violent tone of, maybe he should start killing his enemies, and that he should stop giving people second chances, is starting to really rub off on him, and that maybe he should just give it all, that's it, kill and just become Daredevil and kill his enemies to keep the city safe, because he can no longer balance two lives and give people the chances that they deserve. So that is Season 2 of Daredevil in a nutshell. So let's move into Season 3 now. And the action and all that was really good in Season 2 and all that. So that's cool. Now we're on to Season 3 of Daredevil. This season follows after the events of The Defenders. Matt fights Elektra, who was resurrected by the Hand, and pretty much what they do, which is the ninja organization that, they kind of fight in Season 2. And now that, he's starting to leave Matt Murdock in the shadows and just become Daredevil, he was struggling with that fact at the end of Season 2, and now after the defense of the Defenders and everyone thinks he is dead, he comes back. He's still alive, thankfully, and now he just lives his life as Daredevil. And now that Wilson Fisk came out while he was, supposedly dead, and now, all the work that he kind of did in Season 1 is undone, now he manipulates his way out of prison, and he's officially out of prison. And he now is ready to, he's ready to put an end to Daredevil, and he's ready to make the city a better place like he always had dreamed, by corrupting the FBI, the cops, and many more, criminals to make it so that Wilson Fisk is now pretty much almost in charge of Hell's Kitchen. He gets that far. Matt is ready to go to that point, and he's tempted to really just cross the line, and he's really tempted to go and just kill Wilson Fisk. He's troubled. He becomes more violent, and now he just knows that he's ready to cross that line, and he's really close, and he wants to kill Wilson Fisk. He's now on that Punisher level. He struggled with that in season, you know, 2. Now he's officially going to try to do that in season 3. He's given his criminals less chances, and he's really getting close to just wanting to kill Wilson Fisk, because in order for him to win, he has to cross that line. Kind of like Spider-Man, in order for, you know, Spider-Man to win, Peter Parker has to lose. I guess in this case, in order Daredevil to win, you know, Matt Murdock has to lose. And I guess that it's getting to that point now where he can't do anymore. We also have 2 new characters. Ray Nadim, played by J.R. Lee, plays the character really well, as Point Dexter, played by Wilson Benthal. And both these characters are really cool, especially Point Dexter, or Dex. He basically plays the alternate level of Daredevil, the one that is willing to, basically the fact that, he kind of acts as, you know, they share very similar, backgrounds as kids, you know, both Dex and Matt Murdock, and they, you know, Dex kind of becomes like a alternate version of Matt Murdock, Bullseye, who kind of imitates the fact of him just being violent and taking no chances, and just him being violent, and basically represents him being, you know, fully just a Daredevil and not Matt Murdock, because Matt Murdock keeps Daredevil on the right path and keeps him from crossing that Punisher line. This season, he's pretty much ready to do that, but after Dex comes out of the shadows, it makes Matt rethink if he really wants to become that violent or not. And not battling someone like that, it truly starts to mess with Matt if he wants to put Wilson Fisk down, because Wilson is just crossing a line. And now, Wilson Fisk uses Dex to make the public think that, you know, Daredevil is a bad guy. He dresses in a Daredevil suit, and now that the public thinks that Daredevil is a bad guy, now what they're going to do is, now he's not only generally hated, but he just is in a struggle between, does he want to cross the Punisher line? He now has somebody that in his lifetime that is basically imitating him and bullying him and teasing to that fact and torturing him over that fact. He has a villain that he just wants to take down, a man who just wants to torture him because he, you know, Matt thought he by doing the right thing by putting him away, a man that he knows already that he's doing the right thing, and he wants to put a change to the city, and he's willing to manipulate the person that put him away for that until he breaks him, just kills him. And now Wilson Fisk, you know, wants Daredevil to kill him so bad that, like, he goes to prison and his life is ruined. It's a really cool story. You know, I think it's such a great story, so well written, so well acted. The violence is real this season, the effects are real this season, everyone. It is a great finale to the Daredevil series, and I think that will, you know, again, Vincent D'Onofrio and Charlie Cox do an absolutely beautiful job at playing this role perfectly. And it's really cool when, you know, Point Dexter and, you know, Matt Murdock do eventually meet, because, you know, they do question, you know, oh my god, you know, this is becoming a reality. What do I do? I can't become violent now. So that's all 3 seasons of Daredevil. We'll also be seeing Daredevil in the upcoming She-Hulk series, which will be really, really exciting. So I'll stay tuned for that. So yeah, that is the end of Daredevil, all 3 seasons. So to put it in conclusion, this is a show that is, again, rated MA. You know, it is, I think I already said that, it's rated MA. But yeah, it has beautiful, very nicely well acted, the representation is very nice, it's very New York City-like. I think it was actually filmed in New York, probably was. The villains are nice, the story itself is so neatly put together that it just looks so good. The action is on point the entire show. It is so pure, it is so realistic, and it is so beautiful. That's why this show is so successful. That is why this show is so good. And that is why this show is just probably one of the best, if not the best, Marvel show ever released. So that's my opinion of